geology fans. We join together today to explore the Earth story exposed at the surface to the south of our campus. We depart from the Colorado School of Mines campus and longingly look back to your on-campus field trip where you saw overturned beds of three major formations. The oldest was the Pier Shale, which graded into the Fox Hill sandstone above it, with ash beds dated at about 69 million years ago. The Fox Hills then gave way to the Laramie Formation. In terms of environments, you had an ocean for the Pier Shale, regressing to a beach for the Fox Hills environment, and eventually a fluvial or river environment for the Laramie, which dated at about 68 million years ago. Now, the Laramie, which would appear to be a river whose channel was to the north, had developed levees, which occasionally breached, sending out high-energy crevasse splays onto the future location of the Colorado School of Mines, which at that time was a floodplain with tropical rainforests, with palm trees and dinosaurs. And the two types of dinosaur we directly observed evidence of were Triceratops and Hadrosaur. As the bus leaves the Colorado School of Mines campus, we are hit by the magnificent topography with hard crystalline rocks standing up high to the west. The rocks exposed on the campus show the linear ribbed pattern of layered rock that have been tilted and then differentially eroded. And we are struck that the more resistant sandstones stand up high, whereas the shale and mined areas tend to erode back and sink respectively. Off to the east, we see the Table Mountains capped with their resistant crystalline rock again. The shape of the land is a direct function of the lithology, that is, the rock types below our feet. Our campus is on the edge of two crustal blocks that have moved relative to each other, most recently in the Rocky Mountain uplift. The Front Range block went up, and the Basin block, which the Colorado School of Mines stands on, went down and began receiving sediments eroded from the newly formed mountains. If you drilled a well from the top of the Table Mountains, you would have to go 12,000 feet over 2 miles deep to hit the crystalline Precambrian basement rock that you can simply walk over and touch to our west. We also saw evidence on our campus of a great fault, the Golden Fault, which was a failure mainly along the Pier Shale, which pinched out all the older layers below so they are not exposed in our area. This is why we travel south on this trip and don't have to go too far. Soon we pass through the I-70 road cut and see some of these older rocks being exposed in the Dakota Formation to the east and the Morrison Formation to the west, both of which we will visit today. As we exit I-70 and turn south on 93, we get an overview of most of today's trip. As is consistent along the Front Range, the core crystalline rocks are to the west, and the Dakota Ridge of mostly sandstones we just drove through is to our east. The ridge is made by plunging beds of rock with more resistance to erosion and is called a hogback. The valleys on either side of the Dakota Ridge hogback are underlain by less resistant shales. As we near Red Rocks Park, we can see far down the ridge and note a line of vegetation on the west-facing slope. This is a telltale sign of a change in the rock below. The Morrison Formation below does not allow tree growth for reasons we shall investigate, but the Dakota does, and so the contact between these two units is easily placed on a geologic map as it is painted out in trees on the surface. The concept of inferring geology from the vegetation above, known as biogeology, can be quite useful in many places. We turn into Red Rocks Park with much anticipation, for now we have turned the bus toward those resistant crystalline rocks and start to climb. The formations we see on the way up, we will take a closer look at on the way back down. The fact these formations exist is evidence that this location was once in D-World, but the stark topography made by differential erosion evidences the current E-world that we live in today. Throughout our trip today, we will see D-world going back and forth with E-world as the Earth's surface cycles between deposition and erosion. Coming to the end of the road, we get off the bus and go to the top of the amphitheater to get an overview of the location. Take a moment to look around and discuss with your TA. What are the big features and questions that exist for this location?